Frame rate and integration time are related to each other, and sometimes they are a compromise. If our process line is going, for example, 2 meters per second, and our samples have certain size, what is the frame rate we need to have enough spatial resolution? Let's calculate that.
One question that we always get is how to estimate the achievable sample resolution and sorting speed. This of course depends on the speed of the conveyor belt and the sample size and the required spatial resolution on the sample. But we also need to understand the effect of integration time and frame rate. First, the frame rate means how many measurements we are doing per second. And it is important to understand that the integration times multiplied by the frame rate should always be one or less. Meaning, for example, if we have a frame rate of 100 frames per second, one cannot use higher than 10 millisecond integration time. I will give an example. We have a process line where the speed is about 1000 millimeters per second. And we assume that we have quite small samples that we need to identify and sort flakes of the size 10 times 10 millimeters. If we assume in our experiment that the frame integration time is 10 milliseconds, it means that during this integration time, the flake will move about 10 millimeters from position T1 to position T2. And because we have only 100 frames per second, in this case, we would get only one or even less than one sample per one flake, meaning it's not, we cannot recognize the flake. In practice, we need at least 3 to 4 samples per flake, so calculating backwards, we can say that we need a 250 frames per second, and the maximum integration time we could use is about 2.5 milliseconds.